Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install VSDC Video Editor in a Windows 11 operating system. So, let's begin. Now to install VSDC Video Editor, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, you need to just simply type VSDC Free Video Editor, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this videosoftdev.com. Is basically our first search result. So just need to simply click on this VSDC free video software, and this will going to redirect you to this official site of VSDC Video Editor. In here, you can see that they have these services called Video Editor, Video Converter, Audio Converter, and Audio CD Grabber. So here in this video, I'm going to show you about how to download and install Video Editor. So just simply click on this download button and you'll be seeing this video editor. So just simply click on that and you'll be redirected to this download free video editor page. In here you can see that the file size is 99.2 MB and our latest version is 6.8. Right, so here you need to just simply click on this download video editor and version is 64-bit. If you are using 32-bit operating system, then you need to simply proceed with this link. But since I am using 64-bit, I just simply going to click on this download video editor button. And it will going to start downloading our video editor. So since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see that our video editor called VSDC Video Editor has been directly downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it. And this is going to ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. And you'll be seeing that our VSDC installation wizard has been directly opened over here. So let us first minimize our download directory. And then from this drop down, you can choose your language. So I'd like to choose English. So I'll just simply keep English and then just simply click on OK. And you can see that our installation wizard for VSDC rightly opened. So welcome to VSDC Free Video Editor. Just simply click on Next. And these are the license agreement. Do read this if you have time. Then just simply accept this license agreement. Then just simply click on Next. And it is now currently showing some information about this latest version 6.8. you can always read this, right? And then just simply click on Next, and this is going to be our installation destination. So keep this as a default. If you want to change, you can always do by just simply click on this browse button, right? And then just simply click on Next, and they're going to create this flash integro as a folder. So just simply keep this default. Otherwise, if you want to change, you can always do that by just simply clicking on this browse button, right? And then just simply click on Next again. And under this select additional task, it is asking some additional shortcuts. So do you like to create VSDC Free Video Editor desktop shortcut icon? So I'd like to create a desktop shortcut icon over here, right? And also video capture desktop shortcut icon, or free screen video recorder shortcut icon, whether you'd like to create over here. So I'd also like to create all other icons as well, and I would also like to associate all similar type of projects with VSDC Free Video Editor, so that it just simply double clicking on that project only we can open it using our VSDC Video Editor. So I'd like to check everything, right? And then just simply click on Next. And now it's ready to be installed. So just simply click on Install. And it will going to start installing our VSDC Video Editor. But before that, it will also going to check whether Microsoft Visual C++ 2015 to 2019 is installed on our machine or not. So if it not installed, then it will going to install over here. And after installing that, it will going to install our VSDC Free Video Editor. So you don't need to worry about anything. It will do everything on its own. So you need to just simply give some time. You can grab some coffee or anything, and you can come back. Right, so I'll be also doing the same. I'll be coming back after a couple of minutes. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can clearly see that our VSDC Free Video Editor has been directly installed, and it has, you know, also opened our browser. So you can just simply minimize our browser for the time being. So it will just show a thank you message. You can read it later. And it is currently completing our setup. So just simply check this launch VSDC Video Editor and then just simply click on finish, so that, you know, it automatically launch our VSDC Video Editor, and it has rightly started launching our video editor. So now after it get launched, I'll also show you how to import video and how to edit in any video using VSDC Video Editor. Right, so stay tuned with this video. And you can clearly see that our VSDC Free Video Editor has been rightly opened over here. So right now it's showing whether you'd like to opt for a pro, and is also telling that it has blocked some firewall. So this is just basically the Opera thing, so you just simply cancel it for the time being, because I am currently using. And it is also asking whether you'd like to opt for a pro solution. So if you want to upgrade your VSDC Video Editor, then you can always do that. You need to pay some subscription fee. That's it basically. But for the time being, I would like to just, you know, simply close this, and I will first simply maximize it. Right. And this is basically the interface of a VSDC Free Video Editor. And this is the free edition that we are using. If you want, as I have told earlier just now, if you want to upgrade it, you can always upgrade. Right, this icon is also given over here. But now I'd like to show you how to import any video file and how to edit it. So for that, you need to just simply click on this blank project, and this is going to open this window, project settings. So you just, you know, simply give a project title. I like to keep this as a default, and then just simply click on finish, and you can clearly see that it has, you know, rightly opened a blank slate over here basically. Right, and here we'd like to import a video. So for that, you need to just simply click on this add objects, and from here you need to choose what file you'd like to import. It will be either image, audio or video. So I'd like to choose video. And it will, you know, going to open this window. In here you need to navigate to your video. So I have a video under this videos directory, so just simply go there, and I'll choose just this video. Right, and then just simply click on open, and it is currently telling to choose about this object position settings. So I'd like to keep this as a default, and then just simply click on OK. And you can clearly see that our video has been directly opened over here with our timeline that is over here. So you can always move your cursor and set your cursor on a proper timestamp to basically navigate throughout this video. And if you just simply click on this icon over here, you can see that your video has been directly started running over here. Right, so for the time being, just simply close it. I'll show you if you like to apply any effect on your video. So let's say you want to apply any grayscale. So if you just, you know, simply click on that, you can clearly see that our video has been rightly turned into a grayscale, which is totally black and white, right? And if you want to just, you know, simply remove all effect, then just, you know, simply close it, and our video turn into our normal color that it was there. And if you want to, you know, do some auto level, you can do that. Auto contrast, then also you can do that, right? And if you just simply click on this drop down, you can see that several effects are there, right? So you can choose any effects from here. Let's say you want to choose this effect, it will, you know, going to transfer your video into this effect, right? So in this way, you can easily edit any video on your VSDC Video Editor. You have this cut and join options also. So if you want to cut any sections from this video, you can always do that by just simply clicking on this cut icon, and then you can always export this video as well. So if you need a detailed video on VSDC Video Editor, do put a comment in our comment sections. I'll be happy to make more videos on VSDC Video Editor. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also please to share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.